Isn't there you? So I always feel like things were shaken out a little bit.
But let me push back in our calendar. What are we designing for? We still have, we're going to be recommencing drilling again in 2 months' time, hopefully, inshallah. We still don't know what we're going to be producing. So it's not as if we have a crystal clear idea as to what the facilities need to handle, right? And once we have that, then perhaps there is an argument to do to stop and do a proper feat. But, this equipment has handled 9,500 barrels a day. We didn't think it would handle that. This new equipment is meant to be handling 14,000 barrels a day. There will be some operational issues that the graph and steam will have to handle, but that's more than sufficient to handle the production from the Shuruk concession. And it didn't seem at the time to us to be of value to stop and do a proper feed from
I don't think we don't think it's going to be handy. But it cannot be the file separate.
At the beginning. And this is our path. The real path is this. So once we will install this, we were.
Without you, without ETAP, and without all the contractors, without DGE, without the tractor, really, we couldn't have achieved such success. And I would like, before talking more elaborate, I would like really to first thank DGE for giving us the opportunity to start the production as early as November 1907, rather than waiting, you know, 6 months extra until the publication of the Gazette of the Shirok Concession, which took place in April 25th, 2008. So that really helped in accomplishing the 5 million barrel that we are really celebrating today. Many thanks. You know, this is, although I wrote something but I forget it, you know, this achievement could not have been really done without the close cooperation of various people from Pioneer and ETA partners. They worked very hard during the construction until this moment. And I think within, we have seen, you know, in the short tour we made, everyone is aware of what's going on, aware of the changes needed, aware of the modifications that require. So many thanks, and this could not have been done, of course, without the support of the management of ETAP, Mr. Khaled Bashir, and also the management of Pioneer, represented by Mr. David McManus. So many thanks to them and to their effort. The contractors, there are so many. Really, I don't want to mention names, because I'm sure, like an old man like me, I will skip names, so I don't want to mention names. And there are so many, many thanks to their effort in completing the production facility as, you know, fast as is needed. And also, you know, before last, the effort of TRAPSA, Munji Frika in particular, he is with us today. He allocated more people at the site here to monitor the shipment of the crude from the tanks. We used to have 40 tanks, and it was very difficult to manage on a daily basis and required more personnel to keep it operating on 24 hours. So many thanks to him and to TRAPSA team for this help. And, you know, before last, I would like to thank, you know, David McManus, the Executive Vice President of Operation International, for making the effort of coming from London, you know, to join us for this moment. Khaled Khadour and the rest of the group are very thankful, you know, for making it today with us here. Thank you. Appreciate it.
I'm here because the sun is shining and it never shines in the UK. So so it was nice to get some warm weather on my back. But I won't spend too much time, but let me just go back a little bit in time to when we first had an idea about drilling wells in Shahrukh. It's not that long ago. It's less than 5 years ago when we were struggling, to be honest, with Anadarko as operator of the Shahrukh concession. We really didn't want to drill any wells. And we managed to negotiate a deal with them and take them out of the concession. And it was a brave decision, I think, to Pioneer at that point in time to commit to a drilling rig, the H&P drilling rig, on a two-year commitment. So we had to import the rig from the USA and commence drilling. Now, we didn't have any record of success in Shahrukh to go by there, so that was a very brave decision by Pioneer to commit the money to that exploration program. Fortunately, we were extremely lucky in finding seven successful wells immediately when we commenced drilling. And in many parts, I'm here representing the geoscience team, who are not present here today, but send their thanks also to this gathering. Because I think without the foresight of the geoscience team and their understanding as to how these reservoirs work, we would not be here today. We would not have produced 5 million barrels. So it's a combination of a little gamble on our part and a lot of hard technical grind in the geoscience team that got us here. But having got here and having started to drill some wells successfully, let me compliment all of you, particularly the operations people, in getting this field up and running and very quickly getting to 9,000 barrels a day. I've quoted in a couple of conferences that within 14 months of drilling the first well, we had first production, and within 2 years of first production, we have arrived at 5 million barrels. So that's a tremendous effort by all of you. So, on behalf of Pioneer, I wish to thank the operations people. It could not have happened without all of our contractors. Solidar here, Teletech are here. TRAPSA, of course, for allowing us into their pipeline system. So it's been a huge team effort. And lastly, and not least, I wish to thank our government representatives here today. ETAP have been a phenomenally welcome partner into this. I've worked in many countries where we've had to work with state companies, and let me tell you emphatically that ETAP are the best company, the best NOC that I've ever had the experience of working with. So my thanks to you, Callum, and your team. But also Jamila, not to be outdone, I think DGE have been tremendous in assisting us. You are one of the most flexible governments. You understand what your focus is, which is get oil produced. And as Hashim kindly said, you know, without the assistance of DGE right up front, we wouldn't have produced 5 million barrels either. So I think the combination of ETAP and DGE deserve a special mention. So thank you to both of you.
And I'm not fluent in